Hi guys, my name is Nicole and I'm on the Customer Advocacy Team at Scott's Cheap Flights. Today, I want to talk about Google Flights. Although it's only been around for a few years, Google Flights has become the single most powerful flight searching tool on the internet today. Almost all the deals we send out with Scott's Cheap Flights can be found on Google Flights. What's good about Google Flights is that it's super fast. The results pop up almost instantaneously, whereas with other flight search engines, you could be waiting from 10 to 30 seconds for your results to appear. And this is true whether you're searching a single set of dates or months worth of fares. It's also powerful with tons of customizations to help people find the best flight possible. More on that in the how-to section. What's bad about Google Flights is that it only searches directly with the airline or with a handful of the more prominent OTAs like Orbitz, Priceline, or Expedia. And though these are the most known and trusted OTAs, they're not necessarily the cheapest. Momondo, on the other hand, searches dozens and dozens of OTAs and almost always finds the cheaper price. I'll do a Momondo tutorial soon. And so, if you're ready, let's get to flight searching. So, as you've probably already noticed, Google Flights knows where I am. I'm currently located in Wellington, New Zealand, and my departure is showing from Wellington. If I click this plus symbol, I'm also given the option to search from airports located near me. What's amazing about Google Flights is that I can put in up to 5 different airport codes to search from. I say airport codes and not city codes or metropolitan codes, because some cities can actually count towards multiple airports. For example, NYC, you have LGA, EWR, and JFK. I don't want to look for flights from Wellington or New Zealand for that matter today, so I'm going to go ahead and delete that and put in 5 different airport codes around the US. So first, I'll start with CLT for Charlotte. I'm going to put a comma and a space. How about DFW for Dallas, BUF for Buffalo, PDX for Portland, and how about SEA for Seattle? Always be sure to check your airport codes, because if you just mess up on one letter, you could be searching from a completely different country. Just as with the departure, I can choose up to 5 different airport codes for the destination. Today, I want to look for flights to South America, so I'm just going to put in a handful of South American airport codes. So we have LIM for Lima, SEL for Santiago, BOG for Bogota, GRU for Sao Paulo, and EZE for Buenos Aires. Now I'll go ahead and choose my departure date by clicking the date just below my departure airports, and immediately I'll see 2 months worth of fares pop up. I'm looking for flights in the springtime, so I'm going to go ahead and scroll through the months to find the best flight in the spring. So I'm going to choose to depart on the 12th, and you can see my return date is already highlighted, so I'm going to return 1 week later on the 19th. These prices are round trip. And now I can choose my outbound flight. Of course, the cheapest flight is going to be highlighted in green. So I'm going to click on this one. And now I can choose my return. And of course, I'm going to choose the cheapest one. Just another reminder to please check your itinerary before booking. If I scroll down, I'm shown where I can book. And since this flight is operated by Delta, I can book directly with Delta. If I click here, I'll be taken to the Delta booking page where I'll enter all my information and check out like any other online transaction. So as I said before, one of the features that makes Google Flights so powerful is the ability to customize. Now I'd like to show you a few different customizations that you can do to help you find the best flight possible for you. First up, we have stops. So if I click here, I can actually set a preference for whether I want to fly nonstop, I'm willing to stop once, or even twice. Next, if we click airline, I can actually filter out results for an airline that I want to avoid. Or on the other hand, if I'm a loyalist to another airline, I can make sure that I only see results from that airline. So for example's sake, let's say I want to avoid flying with Spirit, I can just scroll down and put an X on Spirit and I won't see any results from Spirit. But what about the Delta loyalist? If I only want to see results from Delta, I can just scroll down and give Delta a tick. And now my results not only don't include Spirit, but they only include Delta. Next, if I click more and change the duration, I can actually use this as a way to avoid long layovers. Google Flights always defaults to economy, but if I click here, I can actually change my preference to premium economy, business class, or first class. Next, I'd like to show you how to track prices. If you're already logged into your account, all you have to do is turn track prices on, and it will consider the preference that I've already set. And just to be sure that it's working, you can go ahead and click View All and scroll up and make sure that email notifications are turned on. So now I'd like to talk about my personal favorite feature of Google Flights, and that's the Explore Destinations map. So let's go ahead and click on the map, and I'm gonna go ahead and enter my departure airport, which was Buffalo. So sticking with the theme, I'm actually gonna go ahead and put in South America. And this is the amazing thing about Google Flights, that not only can I put in cities or countries, but I can also put in whole continents or regions like Southeast Asia. So let's put in South America and see what we find. And I'm gonna go ahead and choose my dates again. They were in April, I think it was April 12th to the 19th. So a few prices I can already see loaded. And this is really incredible because before I was able to search 5 different airports, but now I can see hundreds of airports and maybe some that I actually forgot. I searched to Bogota before, but I didn't think to search to Cartagena. I can zoom in a bit and see a few more options, but it's looking like Colombia might be my best bet. And you know what? I want a beach vacation, so instead of going to Bogota like I originally planned, I'm gonna pay $40 more and go to Cartagena. All I have to do is click on Cartagena, and all I have to do is click on Show Flights, and I'm immediately taken to the familiar page that we've already gone over. So this brings me to my final topic of the video, and that's troubleshooting. People usually run into two different problems with Google Flights, and that's cached results and phantom fares. The first, cached results, is when the fares that initially pop up are actually incorrect, and when you start clicking around, they change. When you first put in your departure and your destination, Google Flights will auto-populate a sample search not too far in the future. So for example, if I want to change these auto-populated dates, let's say I scroll on over to June, it looks like it's telling me that if I depart on the 6th, I'll be paying $502 round trip. But actually, if I click on the 6th and select return the 13th, I'll only be paying $442 round trip. And if I go back to the calendar and check on the 6th, the price is now displaying correctly, $442 round trip. The easiest way to overcome cached results is just by selecting any other dates other than the initial auto-populated ones that Google gave you to begin with. Doing so gets rid of the cached results and allows you to see more accurate prices for all the months. The second one is something that we loathe at SEF, and that's phantom fares. This happens when Google Flights or an OTA says a fare is available, but it actually can't be booked. Phantom fares usually reveal themselves in two forms. The first is when Google Flights actually gives you a quote and the price jumps once you select your preferred flights. This usually is an indication that the fare has changed very recently and the older, cheaper price is no longer bookable. Second is when you've selected your preferred flights, but there's actually no button to book, but instead you're directed to call the airline. Don't even waste your time calling, because if you can't book online, you probably can't book over the phone either. Better to use your energy towards finding more deals.
And so you have it. That's how we find cheap flights here at Scotch Cheap Flights on Google Flights. Anyway, if you found this video helpful, why not give me a big thumbs up? Or why not share it with a friend? That's all for today. I hope you join me next time when we take a look at Momondo. Thanks for joining me and happy flight searching.